Welcome back. I'm here again with Brian Buckley to talk about minimising any waste we have in our pits. As we know, Brian, some pits can have as high as 10 or 15% waste in our pit. And especially after a year like last year, no farmer can afford to have that much waste. What are some of the important points that we should be looking for to minimise any waste in our silage pits?
I suppose as the grass is coming in off the field now, there will be a lot of fields around that silage pit. So take your time, give the man on the pit and the loader a bit of time to roll. Bring it in layers. And if it is a big enough pit, put a second machine on it. That one machine is bringing up the grass and the second one is rolling.
We all know it's important to get an airtight seal in our pit. Can you talk us a bit about that?
The most important thing is getting the air out of that clamp straight away. So this is the start of the fermentation stage. When you have that clamp completely sealed, the pH will start to drop.
Most of the waste comes along the sides or on the top layer of the pit. What's the best way to ensure as tight a seal as possible in these areas?
Once all that grass is in the pit, roll it, give it that final roll, and it's time to get that plastic on straight away. There's no benefit leaving that clamp open. Where there is a lot of waste on tops and sides, especially with clamps that have walls, I would definitely say don't go over the walls, because that's when you see a lot of waste up on the sides. I also like to see on walls, especially covers covering the walls, and these are folded in when it comes to sealing.
What's our best way in ensuring good weight on top of the pit?
Most farmers use tyres, but also, especially along the edge, I like to see the likes of sandbags. Also, I like to see the use of an oxygen barrier, cling film type product that will prevent waste on top. After a week, you will see the clamp will start to drop down a bit, come back and tighten up the tyres or any weight that is on top of it again.
That's great, Brian. Join us again for more videos on making quality silage.